Yes, senhor, this is your sister again. As I'm inviting, please keep on inviting. We have a special message today that will boost you to your next level. That will really teach you the word of God. Some of them that you have never heard before. I pray may God help us in Jesus' name. Please, as I'm inviting, keep on inviting. May God bless you if you do so in Jesus' name. Please share this video. Share it and invite. Please share this video. Share it and invite. May God bless you in Jesus' name.
And mention of your name under the moon.
Please don't mind my voice, so because I've been traveling for long. I've been traveling, so my voice is already crackled. But we are still going to teach ourselves to the glory of God. Please, as you are going to fellowship with me, please hold your Bible. I want you to hold your Bible. As I'm reading my own, you will also be reading your own. Thank you. May God bless you. Please, I'm inviting people that are watching me in Facebook. Please, share this video. Invite as many that you can invite. Invite your friends and family so that we all will partake in this this video, this teaching today. May God help us in Jesus' name. Amen. Please keep on inviting. I'm still inviting as many that I can invite. Please, join me to invite people. Share this video. May the Lord continue to protect and guide you all in the mighty name of Jesus. Share the video. Invite as many that you can invite. Almighty God will bless you. He will protect you and guide you. So, please. Share the video, invite. May God bless you in the name of Jesus. Because today we have a lot of topic to talk about. We have many things to talk about today. So may God bless you all in Jesus' name. This is your sister. Love it, mommy. Let love lead. So we have a very special topic to talk about today, because according to the revelation that God gave to me, He said you should turn my people away. Turn my people away from their ignorance, because ignorance are eating my people up. Turn them away from their ignorance. So today we are going to deliberate on some verses that will boost you, that will try tell you how to do things in the way of God, so that the name of the Most High God will be glorified. Please, invite as many that you can invite. My YouTube is on, my Facebook is also on also. Please, if you have never subscribed to my YouTube, just let it know, will take you time to touch that red button. There's a red button there. The road to subscribe. Just touch the red button one, so that's you are subscribed. Touch it second time, so that you will be getting all, whenever I upload a video, or whenever I'm online, you will see it. Just click the red button of subscribe. Please, subscribe to my YouTube channel. It's Mommy Let Love Lead. Mommy Let Love Lead TV. Subscribe to it. Touch that red button there. It will not take you seconds. It will not take you minutes. It's not even a second. Just touch that red button. Then you will subscribe. So that we'll be teaching ourselves together whenever we come out like this. May God Almighty bless you. As you obey God and as you obey the word of God and subscribe to that YouTube channel. That is Mommy Let Love Lead. Just touch the red button. God Almighty will bless you. He will protect you. In fact, you are wonderful. All of you that have subscribed, you all are wonderfully and fearfully made. May God bless you all in Jesus' name. Amen. So, we are going to start. I'm going to pause the... Yeah.
I never know you will favor me this way. I never know you will favor me this way. I never know you will favor me this way. Favor me this way. Thank you, my Lord, that day. I never know you will honor me this way. I never know you will honor me this way. I never know you will honor me this way. Honor me this way. Thank you, my Lord.
Father, in the mighty name of Jesus, Father, we thank you, we glorify your name. Father, we exalt your name. Father, King of glory, we are going to start now. Father, start with us in the name of Jesus. My Father, my Lord, my God, Jehovah Nissi, Jehovah Jireh, Jehovah El Shaddai, Elohim, the omniscience God, the omnipresent God. Father, I call upon your presence to be with us now in the name of Jesus. Father, King of glory, let your presence be with us. Let your anointing be with us. Let your glory be with us in the mighty name of Jesus. Father, cover us with your amazing grace in the mighty name of Jesus. Father, King of glory, let me not speak a word of my own. Father, King of glory, come and speak through me in the mighty name of Jesus. My Father, Abba, Father, speak through me, O God. Father, King of glory, as I begin to release your word, O God, Father, let your children listen, O God. Father, King of glory, show your children the truth. The truth and the way, so that they will turn away from every captivity that they have been in, so that they will believe in you. Return all of them to your glory in the mighty name of Jesus. Father, I thank you. I glorify your name. Father, have mercy upon our life. Forgive our sin and our iniquity. Forgive us for that you have asked us not to do that we are still doing. Thank you, King of glory. Thank you, Heavenly Father. Father, let your will be done for your name alone to be glorified. In Jesus' name, I pray. Amen. My brethren, this is your sister. We have a lot to talk about today. May God bless you all. As you all have worshiping me and fellowshipping with me, may God continue to protect and guide you all. May God bless you all. You will not end this week with tears. You will end it well. God will give you divine connection that will boost your life. Divine connection that will boost your life. God will favor you. He will bless you. That you have been asking God for, God will reach to your heart desire. Accordingly, in the mighty name of Jesus.
May God bless you all. So we are about to start now. Please, as you are fellowshipping with me now, please carry your Bible also. So today's topic is know who you are. Today's topic is know who you are. Know who you are. Believe and trust in your God. That is today's topic. Today's topic is know who you are. Believe and trust in your God. Today is 22 of May 2019. The topic is know who you are. Believe and trust in your God. Even though somebody is trying to pull you down, know who you are. Even though people are criticizing you, know who you are in Christ. Even though people are using their mouth to crucify you, but know who you are in Christ. Believe and trust in your God. And God will always represent himself in your life. Don't because of anybody deviate from God. Don't because of anybody do what God has asked you not to do. Continue doing the God's work so that the name of the Most High God will be praised. Let God hear your word in heaven and say, yes, that is my daughter. That is my son. Don't work for people to appreciate you. Do it for God to appreciate you. That is God for you. God, he always rewards people that are doing good. That's why he said, people that are doing evil, he will perish them. But if you are doing good, he will reward you. So know who you are in Christ. Believe in your God. Believe and trust in your God. Don't let anybody deviate you. So today we are going to read more scripture. At this time, why I'm telling you that you should, no matter what you will do, people will not appreciate it. No matter what you will do, Jesus Christ came to the world. He died for us. He suffered for us. He was preaching the gospel. He did not do any wrong. He did not do any bad to anybody. Rather than blessing people, healing people, at the end, they still kill him. They crucify him. If the world can crucify Jesus for what he had, for the good he did, who am I? If somebody is crucified, if somebody criticizing me, who am I? So, anybody can criticize you. But your own, so that it will not affect you. I'm talking to the children of God, the preachers, the teachers. If you are doing good in the eyes of God, or you are doing good thing, and people are, they are trying to criticize, they are trying to pull you down. Don't pull yourself down, no. Know who you are in Christ. Trust and believe in God. Your God will always see you through. So that is my topic today. Know who you are. Believe and trust in God. Even though people are trying to pull you down, God is God. He's never a man. Neither will he be a son of man that needs to repent. He's still God. From all Jesus did. At this point, let us go to the book of Mark 6, so that we will not. I know we are going to take a long time today, but please just bear with me because we have to know the word of God, so that we will not be acting again at ignorance. If you know the word of God, nobody can put you at bondage. Nobody can bondage you. Nobody can shame you if you know the word of God. If you know the word of God, nobody can bondage you. Nobody can slave you. Except you don't know the word of your Father in heaven. So let's quickly go to the book of Mark. No, real life, my sister. Yeah, real, real life.
Okay, okay, okay.
So, sorry for that call because I have to let them know. If not, they would disturb me. It's my honorable sister. She would disturb me, so I just have to tell her. So, let's go to the book of Mark. Please, I'm teaching now, please. I don't want to teach alone. Let us do it together. As I'm carrying my Bible, you also carry your Bible. Because some people do say, people are preaching YouTube and Facebook, they cannot explain what they are preaching. Hi, to God be the glory. The God that created me, He remains the same God of yesterday, today, tomorrow, and forevermore. He remains. If God revealed Himself to me, He revealed the explanation to me. God never lied. So I wonder why some people will say people are preaching, they cannot explain what they are preaching. But not Jesus Christ. What they still do more than that to Jesus. So let's quickly go to the book of Mark 6. The book of Mark 6, verse 1 to 6. Please, as I'm reading, read with me. Carry your Bible, read it. Because that is what I always said every time when I'm live like this. I also always tell people that carry your Bible and read with me. So I wonder how I cannot explain what I'm teaching. Please carry your own Bible. If you see that what I'm teaching is not right, you are free to just leave your message. Write it down that it's not right. There is time that God wants to release us from bondage, from slave. Thank you, Jesus. The book of Mark, chapter 6, Mark 6, verse 1 to 6. Verse 1 said, Jesus left the place and said, Jesus left the place and went back to his hometown, followed by his disciples. On the Sabbath, he began to teach in the synagogue. Many people were there, and when they heard Jesus there, were all amazed. Where did he get all this? All amazed. Where did he get all this? They ask. What wisdom is this that he's begin giving him? How does he perform? This is dark. How does he perform miracle? In verse 3, is he the carpenter, the son of Mary, and the brother of James, Joseph, Judah, and Simon? Harris, his sister, live here, and so they rejected him. You see, that is why Jesus said, prophet is not honor in his own town. He go to his own town. That's why Jesus did a lot of miracles in everywhere, but his own town did not accept him. So if your church did not accept what you are doing, they are not appreciating you. Or your family members are not appreciating what you are doing. Or your friends are not appreciating what you are doing. Jesus said they don't want to Jesus Christ too. So why are you killing yourself? In some time they don't accept him. You cannot be your... And as you are not, they ask them questions. See, this thing power where you they use now, how did you get it? They look at as common person. Huh? Not be this one, this capital son. Not be this James' brother.
No, be this Simon brother. They commonized him. And they rejected him. Jesus answered to them. Say, prophets are rejected. The prophets are respected everywhere except in their own town. And they and by their really and by their relative, he said and by their relative and their family. You see, prophets, they respect him in every way, but in some time, it's not, they will not follow him in some time. You see, even their relative will not follow him. Even their family will not follow him. So if they start it in your tongue, are we supposed to cry? No! Because they have been doing it for long. They started with the name of Jesus Christ. May God help us. In verse 5, he answered. In verse 5, he said. In verse 5, I'm reading my own from Good News. You can read your own King James version or anyone. I'm reading my own for Good News. In verse 5, he was not able to perform any miracle there, except that he placed his hand on a few sick people and he was gently surprised. He was greatly surprised because the people did not have faith. He did not do any miracle in his own time, except just few sick people that he laid his hand and healed them. Except few people that he laid his hand and healed them. To him, he said it was greatly surprised to him that the whole time they did not receive him. So if you are doing anything in your church or in your family, in your friends, and they are not respecting or they are not accepting you, they are rejecting you, you see that even the time of Jesus Christ, they did the same thing to Jesus. So who am I? That is why he said a prophet does not honor in his own time. But if you go to another time, they will honor you. This period I traveled, people acknowledged the grace of God in my life. People acknowledged the grace of God in my life. Thank God for Jesus. So at this point, let's go to 2 Timothy. 2 Timothy verse 2. As I'm reading, you can read with me, please. I want us to teach ourselves. Where I'm making wrong, write me. That this place you are wrong, write me, please. We all are teaching ourselves. Because God said if you cannot praise him, he will raise a stone to praise him. In my time, God forbid. God forbid. So 2 Timothy, verse 2 Timothy verse 2, from 14 to 26. Look at my Bible. I'm reading from Good News. You look at it. I'm reading from Good News. You can read your own from KJ version or anywhere, but make sure you carry your Bible. Read with me. 2 Timothy verse 2 from 14. He said, remind your people of this and give them a solemn warning in God's presence, not to fight over words. It does not good, but only runs the people who listen. Do your best to win full approval in God's sight as a worker who is not ashamed of his work, one who certainly teach the message of God truth, the message of God truth. Keep away from profanes and foolish discussion, which only drive people further away from God. Such teachers is like an open sore that eats always the flesh. Two men who have taught such things are Emmanus and Philetus. They have left the way of truth and have upset the faith of truth and are upset the faith of some believers by saying that our resurrection as our resurrection has already taken place, but the solid foundation that God had laid cannot be spoken, and on it are reading this word. The Lord knows those who are this, who are his, and those who say that they belong to the Lord must turn away from wrongdoing. You see it? If you say you love God, you must turn away from wrongdoing. In a large house, there are dish and bowl and bowl of all kind. Some are made of silver and gold. Some are made of silver and gold, of wood and clay. Some are for special occasion. Others for ordinary use. Those who make them, serve clean from all those evil things. We be used for special purpose because they are dedicated and useful to their master, already to be used for every good deed. Avoid the passion of youth and strive for righteousness. Faith, love, and peace, together with those who with a pure heart come out to the Lord for help, but keep away from foolish and ignorant ultimates. You know that they end up in quarry. As the Lord's servant, you must not quarry. You must be kind towards all. A good and patient teacher who is gentle as you correct your obtuseness, for it may be that God will give them the opportunity to repent and come to know the truth, and then they will come to their senses and escape from the tribe of the devil who had caught them and made them obey his will. So I just take them one by one so that people will understand. You see what Bible said here. See, as a teacher, as a preacher, as a pastor, as a worker, say you don't need to quarrel with your people. You don't need to quarrel. I'm reading 2 Timothy verses from 14 to 26. Say you don't need to quarrel with them. He said because you need to pray for them and bring them closer to you. You don't know and correct them. You don't know if that is the way that God wants to bring them to himself. If you correct them and bring them to yourself, say God will give them another opportunity so that their sense will come back to them and they will escape from that tribe of the devil that make them to obey the will of devil. But this time around, no pastor, no worker, some of them, they will be quarreling with their workers, their members, over what is not value for anything. Because this word said everything in this world is vanity upon vanity. You will see pastor quarreling over tithe and offering, quarreling over people preaching in the YouTube and Facebook. Anything you do, you see them quarreling with you. But here I make it clear that God said they should not quarrel with anybody. They should bring them closer Maybe that is the way that God wants to set that person free. But these days, may God help us in Jesus' name. So this time, we are still going to the book of 1 Timothy verse 1 and 2. 1 Timothy 1, verse 1 and 2. 1 Timothy 1, verse 1 and 2. In Jesus' name. Amen. Okay, 1 Timothy 1. Please, as I'm reading, read with me, please. Carry your Bible, also reading with me, so that we all, we got it clear. So 1 Timothy 1, verse 1 and 2, he said, from Paul, an apostle of Christ Jesus, by order of God. Jesus, by order of God, our Savior, and Christ Jesus, our hope. To Timothy, my true son, in the faith, my God, the Father, and Christ Jesus, our Lord, give you peace, give you grace, mercy, and peace. You see, if you are really doing the things of God, people are criticizing you. What did he say here? He said he will give you peace. He will give you grace. And he will give you mercy. So, why are you afraid? Why are you afraid? Continue doing the work of God. Why you they do like say you not sabi my God? I be you not no say Jehovah na God. Keep on doing it. God will give you peace, grace, and mercy. So now we are going to another verse. Now we are going to the book of Titus. Titus 3, verse 9 and verse 8 and 9. Titus 3, 8 and 9. It's time we know the truth. We will never be slaves forever.
It's time we know the truth. We will never be slaves forever. May God help us. I'm searching for the book of Titus. Titus 3:8-9. Thank you, Jesus. See, this is a true saying. I want you to give special emphasis to this matter, so that those who believe in God may be concerned with giving their time to do good deed, which are good and useful for everyone. But avoid stupid. Right? Say, but avoid stupid. Not be me they talk about. The Bible they read. This is the Bible now they read them. I'm reading from the book of Titus 3:1-2. Say, but avoid stupid ultimates, long list of ancestral quarry, and fight about the law. They are useless and worthless. Give at last to warning. What did he say then? We should stop fighting ourselves. We should stop quarreling for anything. You see this one preaching, quarrel will come. Another one will preach, quarrel will come. Who tell you that God cannot raise anybody to preach the word of God? Who tell you? What are you quarreling for? What are you bypassing them for? What are you having them for? You forget that God said in the book of Psalm 30 that even though we human beings cannot praise him, he will raise a stone, but not in my time. But look at what he said here. He said we should stop quarreling over nothing. You see this time, pastor will see the members preaching, he will quarrel over it. Workers will see the other worker that is doing greater than him or her, he will quarrel over it. Father and mother, brothers and sisters, see that the other one is getting better, the other one is not doing well as the other one, they will quarrel over it. They will bypass over it. They will heavy you over it. Bible said, the book of Titus said, we should stop it. God can raise anybody to preach his word. God can raise anybody to preach his word. Stop fighting the children of God because they are preaching the gospel. Because they are preaching the gospel, stop fighting the children of God. Because even before the pastors now, there was pastors before. Even before the workers now, there was a workers before. Before Whatever Tom work again and stop it. The reason you rejected Jesus Christ, baby, way. Then you want us to reject him, honey. I don't want to preach against him, honey. When I preach, what he explain, eh? When I go, I preach, what he explain, eh? May God have mercy upon you people. And my God has told me that those people, they need deliverance. See, anybody that do a thing like that, he need deliverance. He possess. Any worker, any pastor, workers, pastor in the church that is fighting against somebody that is preaching or teaching the word of God, or God said we should go and do evangelism. Then when I'm not doing, when somebody is not doing evangelism, the pastors and workers are not fighting against the person, you are possessed. You need deliverance. Look at what he said here. What the book of Titus said. He said, but avoid stupid arguments. So you should avoid all those people. Because yeah, that was called them? Stupid. Not me that said it. Read the book of Titus 3 verse 1 and 2. Titus 3 verse 8 and 9. He called them stupid. But when they want to preach it to you, they will turn it upside down. May God help us. And God continue to give us the understanding. He will give us the strength to carry his word. The word of God still remains J and Amen. And nobody can change it. In the name of the Lord be praised. I will never be shaken because somebody wants to shake me. I will continue doing the work of my God. I will continue saying the truth. And the truth will set me free. So we should not be stupid. We should avoid those people. Avoid them. That is what he said. We should avoid them and avoid their quarrel. I have traveled this time. I have heard a lot of things. We are pastor. We say members leave the church. We have to celebrate. There are some members that I heard from a one pastor that said if members leave the church, so there are some members that will leave the church. A pastor, the church has to celebrate because they are not contributing anything to the church. They are not doing anything to the church. If they leave, we have to celebrate. It amazed me. They amazed me. So if members leave your church, you continue to celebrate. Where God said, bring them and teach them the word of God. See, that is where he wants to take his glory. Then if you are not doing like that, how do you call yourself a pastor? How do you call yourself a worker? If the members leave your church, you will be celebrating. May God help us. May God help us. So today we are going to deliberate on some verses in the Bible. Because it's time we open our eyes. So now we are going to 2 Thessalonians. 2 Thessalonians. May God help us, eh? May God deliver us. Second Thessalonians 3, verse 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 4, 5, 6, 7. Second Thessalonians 3, verse 1 to 7. I read, say, finally, our Father pray for us that the Lord message may continue to spread rapidly and be received with honor, just as it was among you. Pray also that God will rescue us from wicked and evil people, for nothing everyone believe to the message, believe the message. But the Lord is faithful, and he will strengthen you and keep you safe from the evil, one. And the Lord give us confidence in you, and we are sure that you are doing, and we continue to do what we tell you, In verse 5, may the Lord lead you unto a greater understanding of God, of God's love, and the endurance that is given by Christ. I pray that may God lead you to that greater understanding and the endurance that is given by Christ, in Jesus' name. Amen. So, you hear it now. So let nobody deceive you anymore. Whatever that is, if you're preaching on it that is not in the Bible, write me and let me see it. So now we are going to the book of Matthew. Matthew 12, verse 9 to 14. Now I read. Thank you, Jesus. Matthew 12, verse 9 to 14. So Jesus left that place and went to a synagogue where there was a man who had a paralyzed hand. Some people were there who wanted to accuse Jesus. Of doing wrong. So they asked him, is it against our law to heal on the Sabbath? Jesus answered, what if one of you had a sheep and it fell into a deep hole on the Sabbath? Will you not take hold of it and left it out? He asked them. And a human being is worth much more than a sheep. So that our law does allow us to help someone on the Sabbath. In verse 12, then he answered to the man, he answered to the man with the paralyzed hand, stretch out your hand. He told the man, stretch out your hand. He stretched out his hand. It became wet again, just like the other one. Then the Pharisees left and made plans to kill Jesus. You see why the Pharisees made plans to kill Jesus? Because he healed somebody. Because he healed the man that was paralyzed. Because he healed the man that was paralyzed. And then I saw what I would say. If I saw you say, I can obey your mother. I command you say, I didn't ask one. We have a plan to kill Jesus Christ. What did they plan to kill Jesus Christ for? Because he healed the man that paralyzed on Sabbath day. The Pharisees, they plans to kill Jesus. That is exactly this is what we are passing through today. This is exactly what we are passing through today. If you are going to the church, they will not want you to grow. If they say that you are growing up, they will look for a way to bring you down. If you are in the society that all of them, they want to do oka, and you are now coming out, they will make sure that they will bring you down so that people will not hear from you. People will not hear of you. God has raised you up. He has raised you up to do his work. No man, no woman can break you down in the name of Jesus. Everyone that tried to bring us down, because we are preaching or we are teaching the word of God, that person must go down in the name of Jesus. You see it? Because Jesus Christ healed person, that is why they gathered the one to kill him. Exactly what we are passing through today in the society today. We live today, in the environment we live today, in the church we go to today, in the family we are today, this is what is still going on today. Because Jesus Christ is person, because he healed the leprosy man, the Pharisees, they made plans to kill him. May God help us in Jesus' name. Amen. So, if they are doing whatever they are doing to me, and don't worry, because Jesus Christ has received a lot. Because he healed somebody. And he asked them first, said, if your sheep fall into a hole in Sabbath day, if you will leave them there. Many pastors are doing it too. Sometimes you will call some pastor and will tell you that I'm sleeping. I will come to your place later. Maybe somebody's passing through problem. We'll tell you I will come back later. So we'll tell you come to my house. So we'll tell you I'm not available. And their chief is falling to your home. Their members is in trouble. Their members is in problem. Their members is sick. They will tell you there is a time for them to deliver, not every time. That's why Jesus now asked them, what is your chief? Fall into a hole on Sabbath day. Can you leave them? And he made it clear for them that human being is worth much more than a sheep. Meaning, human being worth more than that you are doing in your house that make you not to go and answer your member when they are passing through difficulties. You said you are their spiritual father, but when they are passing through difficulties, they will not see you. Who type of spiritual father are you? If you cannot attend your members, they are passing through difficulties, you cannot attend them. If you don't see your members in the church, you cannot ask of them. What type of spiritual father are you? Because I have had a lot of what our pastor is doing. I'm talking to all the pastor that is doing all these things. So I pray that may God deliver you all. Because it's not unnormal. He even make it clear here that it's an ancestral spirit. He says it's an ancestral spirit. Ancestral quarreling that is causing it on you people. May God deliver you all in the name of Jesus. Pastor, where the member will be in the hospital, you will not go and visit him. You will not see your member, you will not look for them. Your member, you see your member that is doing evangelism, and you will tell them to do evangelism. When they are not doing it, you begin to preach that they are preaching what they don't know, what they cannot explain. They are causing confusion here and there. One pastor said there are some members that will leave the church that they need to celebrate. I pity you. You need deliverance. You possess. And God will deliver you in Jesus' name. A church that whenever you are spending, you are a member. Whenever you are not, you don't spend, you don't have money to give, they will take you as if you are not valued in the church. That church, the pastor there, he needs deliverance. That is the word of God. God has raised me up to speak the truth, and nobody can pull me down. If you don't kill my Jesus, if you don't kill my God, you can't kill me. So shall it be in your life, all of you that are worshiping me in Jesus' name. Anybody that cannot bring God can down, he cannot bring you down in Jesus' name. Amen. As I'm reading, carry your Bible and read it with me. Now, let us go to another verse. We just read Matthew 12 now. So we are going to Matthew 1, verse 23. I don't have chances to come because I'm betrayed, but today I say I will come and speak with my people that they should wise up. It's time we wise up. It's time we serve God, not the way we are doing it. I will get to some place when God asks that, if anyone say, well, don't pay me something, may tell me I pay him back. Our God is God. Matthew 1. Kneel down by yourself. Pray in your heart. God hear your prayer. God listen to your prayer. God hear your prayer. If you kneel down and pray in your house, God hear your prayer. That does not mean that you cannot go to church. You can go to church, but also be praying in your house. Even though we now you know my yana or seven boma. Inye no man me here now. Baba, inye no mai me here now. Inye no mai me here now. I come and buy me no ria. Inye no mai me here now. Me ni Jesus Christi. Why ni me na yena mawa kaya na me ni Jesus Christi. Eh, me aku waje mi no ria. Aku waje mi ta me ni Jesus Christi. Let's go to Matthew, chapter 23. He said, a virgin will become pregnant and have a son, and he will be called Emmanuel, which means God is with us. So, if God is with you, why are you afraid? Why are you afraid of what man can do against you? Why are you afraid of what will come tomorrow? Why are you afraid of what man or woman can do against you? He said a virgin was born. A virgin was become pregnant. A virgin will become pregnant and have a son, and he will be called Emmanuel, which means God is with us. Matthew 1:23. So God is with me, and God is with you all. No matter what no man or woman can do against me, God, not today, that God is with me. Nobody can pull me down. God is with me. Because I preach the truth of my God. I did not preach whatsoever is not in the Bible. I preach my Bible. That's why I said, when I'm reading my Bible, read with me. If I'm not correct, write it out. May God help us in Jesus' name. At this time, let's quickly go to Genesis. People that said, you are not worth to preach the gospel of God. Let's go to Genesis. Genesis 18 verse 14. I'm reading from Good News. Please, you can read your own from KJV version or anyone. But I'm reading from Good News. Genesis 18 verse 14. Listen, he said, is anything too hard for the Lord? Is anything too hard for the Lord? He put it question mark. Then he said, As I said, 9 months from now, I will return and Sarah will have a son. My own meaning there is, you see it, the word of God remain J and Amen. This hour as he declare it there, that nothing is too hard for him to do. That before you return back, after 9 months, Sarah will give birth to a son, and that word come to pass. If you that is criticizing the preachers, that they are preaching what they cannot explain, and you also are the one that telling us that nothing is too hard for God to do, meaning you are contradicting the word of God, because Bible makes it clear that there is nothing too hard for God to do. God can raise anybody. God can raise a child. He can raise children. He can raise old woman. He can raise old man to preach his word for the name of the Lord to be glorified. It's for his own glory. It's God for himself and by himself. Glory be to God. Who is that person to criticize the word of God? The word of God still remains J and Amen. So, all the verses I have read since, you ought to continue your own and see that God is not lying. He's not a God that lies. That would be a son of man that needs to repent. That's why I'm coming gradually with verses. So, at this time, let's go to Jeremiah 3, verse 2 and 3. While I'm preaching this, I want to let you know that people that said you cannot do this, I want to let you know that you can do more than, because God has given you power. He said the thing that he has done, he expects us to do more than what he has done. Then who will not tell you that you don't claim to preach the word of God? You don't claim to be a prayer warrior. You don't claim enough to be a choir. You don't claim enough to even be a worker. I'm not saying in my Bible that a woman that you cannot bath your husband. You are good. You are going to preach. I don't see where Bible said the woman should be bathing the husband. I'm not saying it. Because I will say my truth until the end. That is out of jealousy. It's out of jealousy. The same thing that did to Jesus Christ when he hit somebody, they plans to kill him. Exactly the same thing when you see people preaching in YouTube or Facebook, you'll be criticizing them. They cannot bath their husband. What is your concern? Are they going to bath you? I've never seen. Please, you that is watching me, if there's any place in the Bible that said woman should be bathing the husband, please write it out. I want to see the verse that said woman should be bathing the husband. So that we know that any woman that cannot bath the husband cannot go to YouTube or Facebook and preach. May God help us. God has raised people up to preach his gospel. And we are not afraid of many that will come. We are doing the work of our Father. And our Father in heaven will protect us and he will guide us. He always with us. Now, let's quickly go to the book of Matthew. No, I just finished Matthew 18:14. So let's go to Jeremiah. So I want to see if I will see where the Bible said a woman should be bathing the husband first before you should go to YouTube and preach. Or maybe if I'm preaching what I cannot explain. Because what I'm preaching here, if I cannot explain this, I'm also reading Bible. So if I cannot explain, if you know how to explain it, write it out and explain it for me. But what I'm reading is Bible. It's not novel. It's Bible. Look at it. Good news. Look at it. It's good news. May God help us. Jeremiah. Let us see what Jeremiah said. Jeremiah 33. Please, you hold on. Please hold on. I don't know what is happening with the YouTube. Please hold on. Let me set the YouTube. I don't know what is happening. Oh my God. Please hear, hold on, because I don't know what is happening with YouTube. So that is it. Now we are in Jeremiah. Jeremiah 33:2-3. Say, the Lord who made the earth, who found it and set it in the place, speak to me. He who name is the Lord said, come to me and I will answer you. I will tell you a wonderful and miraculous things that you know nothing about. You understand it? Good morning, my sister. Good afternoon, dear. Mabel Jo. Good afternoon, my sister. May God bless you. If you don't understand, let me read it again. He said, the Lord who made the earth, who found it and set it in place, spoke to me. He whose name is the Lord said, call to me and I will answer you. I will tell you wonderful and miraculous things that you know nothing about. He said, may you come to run. Even though you never know anything, you don't know how to preach the gospel. You don't know how to do anything. You don't know how to come out and evangelize. He said you should come to him. For what you don't know anything about, he will teach you. He said he will tell you what you don't know anything about. I wonder how people will say, yeah, what type of God that raised this one? Whose type of God that this one is preaching? Because if God said you should come, that he will teach you. May God help us. That is Isaiah. The Jeremiah and me. So now we are going to the book of Romans. Romans 33. Now we are going to the book of Romans. Romans 11:33. Oh. Romans 11:33-36. Listen, my brothers and sisters, listen. Because it's time we wake up. It's time we wake up. Our ignorance is enough. It's time we wake up. He said, how great are God's rich, how deep are his wisdom and knowledge. Who can explain his decision? Nobody. Question, yes. Who can understand his way is a question. As the scripture said, who knows the mind of the Lord? It's a question. Who is able to give him advice? So nobody's able to give God advice. Now what people they decide for God's hand. They say, you know what to do this, you know what to do this, you know what to do this. They are deciding on God's hand. They say nobody decides in God's hand. That's what this paper has said. Romans 11 from 33. So nobody can decide on God's hand. And nobody knows what is in mind. But this time around, people tell you that they know what is God's mind. They hear God speak to them. They know what is in mind. May God help us. He said, no. He said, who is able to advise him? Who has ever give him anything? Who have ever given God anything? May God help us. So that he had to pay it back. Say, who has ever given God anything so that he will pay you back?
Who has ever given? Who have ever given God anything? Say it, so that he will pay you back. For all things we are created by him, and all things exist through him and for him. To God be the glory forever. Amen. All things created by him and for him. Who know what is in God's mind? Who has ever advised him? Who know God's decision? Nobody. Nobody know God's decision then. How did they know the one that is holy and the one that is not holy? Who knows the one that is holy and the one that is not holy? Anybody criticizing you that you are not holy, you know that that person is not holy. He's just looking for who to draw along with him. May God help us. I went to many churches. I was crying. I see a church. They post on, I see something in the internet where one man was confessing that a pastor like him sent him to go and kill another pastor. I said, God, where are we going to? This is GOGO. Another GO sent to go and kill another GO. Then another GO sent to go and kidnap another GO. On YouTube. It's in YouTube. We are watching. When police caught them, they were confessing. Then another man, because pastor wants his wife. Pastor arrest the man because he beat his wife. Because the man beat the wife. Before they bailed the man from a police station, pastor started sleeping with the wife. What type of life are we? And I said, no wonder. Bible said, the judgment of God is going to start from the house of God. Another verse, I just want us to do it fast, so time is going. Now go to the book of Hosea, and you see what God said about all these Pharisees, pastors, Pharisees, workers, Pharisees, no sé qué, no sé cuántos, in the church, in the house, in the community, in anywhere. It is well with us. Searching my Bible so that we all will understand it together. Where you don't understand, just write me, leave the message. I will send it to you back so that you will understand it. Listen to what Hosea 4:6 said. Listen. Before I explain it, Hosea 4:6
He said, my people are dumb. My people, I'm reading from Good News. My people are dumb because they do not acknowledge me. You priests are the pastors. You priests have refused to acknowledge me and have rejected my teaching. And so I reject you and will not acknowledge your son. As my priest said, he will not accept you. He have rejected you and he will not accept your son. He said, in verse 7, he said, the more of you priests there are, the more you sin against me. And so I will turn your honor unto disgrace. You grow rich from the sin of my people. Very making my people to commit sin. You grow rich from the sin of my people. You grow rich. Listen, he's telling. He said these priests, they grow rich from the sin of my people. You know what that one mean? Somebody will go and steal. Will go and pay tax in the church. The pastor will become rich. He will not ask them where they get that money from. Wherever you get money does not concern pastor, for rather you bring the money. They want to reach. Look at what Jesus, what God said here. He said, you grow rich from the sin of my people, and so you want them to sin more and more. You want them to see more and more. You will suffer. Look at it. He said, you will suffer the same punishment as the people. When they clap and follow and they bring the money come. See, he will suffer them, the priest. Those pastors, those ones that they call collecting money from you, and they know what you are doing that is bad, they're still collecting the money from you. So the same way they will punish them, those pastors, the same way they will punish those people that are printing the money. So he will punish you. He said, I will suffer the same punishment. He said, you will suffer the same punishment as the people. I will punish you and make you pay for the evil you do. They will not preach this one to you. Because no one can hear now. No one will preach it out for you to see it. Because no one can send you to run on the right. Oh no, no, no. The way you are making my people to sin, and you are getting rich and rich every day on top of their sin. The same way you go to punish those people, and the same way we punish the priest, they will not preach it. May God help us. All their own is for you to bring. They don't care how you are bringing. They don't care if you are killing people. They don't care if you are a murderer. They don't care what you are doing. They don't even care if you don't have, no matter how you have, come and sow a seed. Come and vow. In fact, they must bring an excuse. If you stop doing, they will not turn you to the Satan in the church. If you are not taking, they begin to ban and cast you. God said, he is there for you. He will save you. So what I'm saying, I want my people to wise. To know their left and their right. Because that was their forces. In the King James Version,
So my people are destroying for lack of knowledge. However, so my people are destroying for lack of ignorance. And say what they sow, they will reap. So let me quickly go to the book of Matthew. Because some people think that without pastor, they cannot pray. Without pastor, you cannot do anything. Without pastor, you cannot sleep. Without evangelist, you cannot pray. Without evangelist, without teacher, you cannot do anything on your own. Listen to what God said in the book of Matthew 6. Listen to it. May God help us. God said in Matthew 6, 7 to 13. Matthew 6, 7 to 13. Listen. He said, when you pray, I'm just slowing on it so that you will listen to it better. He said, when you pray, do not use a lot of meaningless words as the pagan. Do not use a lot of meaningless words as the pagan do. Who think that their God will hear them? Because their prayer are long. Notice that their God will hear them and their prayer are long. He said, do not be like them. Your Father already knows what you need before you ask Him. This, then, is how you should pray. This then is how you should pray. This is how you should pray. Our Father in heaven, may your holy name be honored. This is good news. I'm reading from good news. May your name be honored. May your kingdom come. May your will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us the food we need. Forgive us the wrongs we have done, as we forgive the wrongs that others have done to us. Do not bring us to hard test, but keep us safe from the evil one. In Jesus' name, amen. So today, that is the end of my topic today. May God bless you all. We have really stayed long here today because I want to emphasize and most of the verses that we inspire my people so that they will know their right from their left. Not everyone that will calabash them, then they will begin to put you in the cage. Every bondage, every cage, every evil that anyone wants to put you, their evil will consume them by fire in the name of Jesus. No one will put us in bondage again. May God bless you all. Please, this is the end of my topic. Please, if you are not subscribed to my YouTube channel, just quickly press that subscribe button. If you press it one, you have subscribed. Then if you press it two, anytime I upload a video or if I'm on live, it will notify you. You click it, the red button where they put subscribe. If you press it, you press it, you subscribe, then you will press the notification button so that whenever I upload, it will notify you. My YouTube channel is Mommy Let Love Lead. Mommy Let Love Lead TV. My YouTube channel is Mommy Let Love Lead TV. May God bless you. As you subscribe, God will continue to bless you. In the mighty name of Jesus, God will give you divine connection that will boost your life from grace to grace, from glory to glory, in the mighty name of Jesus. So as we have come to the end of the topic, may God bless you all in Jesus' name. Stay blessed. We'll see next time. I pray that this week you will end it where blessing will locate you, favor will locate you. You will not die in the mighty name of Jesus. Your children will not die in the mighty name of Jesus. Everything in heaven and earth will work for your favor in the mighty name of Jesus. May God continue to protect and guide you. May God give you that divine protection in the mighty name of Jesus. You will end it way. You will end your life way. Every man or woman that is sponsoring evil against you, their evil will return back to them in the mighty name of Jesus. Everyone that is sponsoring tears against you, they will cry your tears in the name of Jesus. I pray, may the good Lord bless you all in Jesus' name. We meet again. See you. Ciao. I love you. Jesus love you all. Mwah. Bye.
Adama.
Gloria amen now. You know magume biye. Call me Gloria. Call me Gloria. Oh my God. Vício, call me Gloria. Oh my Mama. God. Was a woman away.
You can see sister video aí.
Tell me, show me the video.
Es que si no borras memoria, ¿cómo se va a grabar?
Ama por ahí.
Que no, que borres memoria.
¿Por qué no
sé, yo qué sé, pensaba que está grabando.